observed growing up at times was what was referred to as kind of guerrilla filmmaking.
Correct.
And so this was easier, but there was a game to be played.
Oh, let me give you an example. I mean, this would be clear, and there's enough time's gone by. There were producers on the movie. Lovely guys. But some of the stuff they did was a little silly. And the problem was, I know what I'm doing. You know, I'm not a first time. My dad would say, I'm bored at light night, but last night. So I knew I looked like a young guy who had been acting, right. And, you know, why is he directing? And I can understand there might be some vibe on that. I get it, you know. But I know what I'm doing as a filmmaker. And I know what I'm doing as an actor. and I feel solid about that. And I've been, you know, raised in it. So it's very hard to run something by me that I'm not going to get. But it's possible.
Yeah.
Anyway, one of the things they ran by me was I was shooting a group called Guy, and we were doing a dope scene with Guy. Wesley's there, and this is a big scene in New Jack City. And I had the Luma crane, which is this very expensive instrument, like a crane, but it moves all around. The head articulates. You have to have a special operator. So that I had to get Warner Brothers to give me extra special money and get the Luma crane from De Palma, who was shooting Bonfire of the Vanities. So I got the Luma crane over from De Palma. Brian De Palma.
Yeah.
So I got to get it back, you know. And I shot the guy, and I said, okay, great, wrap the Lumicrane out, we're going to finish up with Steadicam, and I'm going to rock some handheld, because it takes X amount of time to get the Lumicrane off the set, pull it off, get it dum-dum-dum-dum. The two producers came to me and said, man, what are you doing? You should shoot some more with the Lumicrane. I said, no, I'm good, I have my shots, thank you. Okay, guys, blah, blah, blah. And they said, no, shoot some more with the Lumicrane. I said, here's the thing, if you want to do that, I will wrap, and then you can continue to shoot more if you want. But that's on you. But the record, the daily record, will show that the director rapped, and you chose to keep the Lumicrane louder, longer. They said, oh, no, man, we forget it, man. You ain't Buddhist, man. You ain't down, brother. You ain't down. I wrapped the Lumicrane. Lumicrane went out. I stayed on budget. Of course, later on, what I find out, they managed the group.
Oh.
They were trying to get a free video.
Oh, that's...
So you have to understand there's those kind of forces.
Yeah.
Now, these are the same brothers that got the movie done, so I ain't mad at it.
Yeah.
But there was little shiesty shit that you had to watch. You had to kind of see around the corners on stuff. Because that same hustle mentality that got the movie up there in the first place, and I have to give them credit for it. They did. Didn't mean that 100% that you couldn't watch them in other areas. You had to know. And then the very next dude that worked with them, he was a director. Young director came to me. He said, "How is it like working with those guys?" I said, "Well, they're really good and they're good at what they do, but they want to direct, and they will try to fire you and get in there as a director." Mm-hmm. And that young brother was named Paris Barkley.
Ah.
And he was directing a House Party too.
Yeah.
And they fired him
and
replaced him with themselves, just as predicted. And they took out an ad in the Reporter saying, from the directors of New Jack City. And when I went to them, I said, you know, the credit is my credit as a director. I said, brother, that's a mistake. I can't believe how the white man would do. Oh, my God, how would he do that? Oh, lordy, lordy.
Oh, you what saw can right we do? Through it.
Yeah,
of course.
But again,
these
were the guys that were smart enough to get it going. They're a big part of why the movie is what it is.
Yeah.
So it's the ability to see the good in them and be honest about the negative.
Yeah.
It's not one or the other. It's the ability to
and just be mindful of all
that. Be mindful.
Say, yeah.
This hustler mentality that can get you there can also make it can be harmful to the project.
Mm-hmm.
If a high tide will lift all ships.
Well, and it sounds like you operated in integrity, and that was what kept you being giving yourself or giving the world a Van Peebles picture that you were proud of.
Right. And part of that was, I mean, there was a huge deal on New Jack City. And part of that was the casting was, you know, when back then, if you were a African-American actor in an action movie, you played the police commissioner. That was understood. You had great lines like, do it by the book or I'm going to have your ass. Now, you've seen many, you know, great.
Yeah.
So we got him over there, but he's not going to be the Mel Gibson.
He's not a threat.
Okay. He's not a threat.
Yeah.
So when we looked at it, we went home and I talked with these producers, and they were, you know, brothers and like myself and very smart. And they laughed. They said, what if we put the white guy in as the police commissioner and let him say, do it by the book, Ice T, or I'll have your ass.
Yeah, yeah.
And I went home. And we laughed about that. And I looked at my family wall. I got white folks. I got black folks. Mm-hmm. I got Asian folks. And I thought, you know what? I get the humor of that, but that's reactionary cinema. Mm. That's get even cinema. That's not doing onto, I don't want to do onto them as they've done onto me. I want to do onto them as I would like them to do onto me, as I would like them to do onto America. Show America, it took Americans of all colors to build this beautiful country. If you don't take pride in it, you unconsciously want to destroy it. Mm. So I went back and said, you know what? Let's mix it up. Let's have Ice-T play the cop, well, Wesley, and that was part of their idea too. I'm not taking sole credit for this. Wesley play the gangster. I'll call it my boy Judd Nelson, who I went to school with. We'll have a Jewish cop. Mm-hmm. And then Russell Wong, who's this great-looking Asian brother, he'll be one of the cops. The attorney who takes Nito down at the end will be a sister of color, a dark-skinned sister of color.
Yeah.
And I'll play the police commissioner and say, do it by the book or I'll have your ass.
So it was intentional.
Yeah. To say, if you wanted folks to say no, you had to give them role models to say yes to. Mm. Cinematically, you had to show the power of being on this side of the equation or that side of the equation. That anyone in that movie who touched the poison died.
Yeah.